doing this, really, but I sort of try, and that is a salat a day, a salat a day. You have to memorize a salat a day. Well, what I try to do is memorize things that I have memorized before, to keep them up to speed, and then try to learn some new things, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
My mother got demented when she was older, and I would take care of her on the weekends, and I had to take the car keys away from her.
Oh.
And when I did, she gave me Mark Antony's funeral oration. Yeah.
You just take one day at a time.
That's right. One day at a time. And one moment at a time.
Yeah.
You know, being, I think, when you're acting, and especially if you take any improv, or you've done any improv?
No, not yet.
No, no. Oh, that's fun. That's good. That's good training. And it keeps you right there, as they say, in the moment. You're right there. You say yes to whatever the people are suggesting.
Yeah.
You go with it, and you stay with it, and you don't give up.
That's right. Yeah. Never give up.
Yeah. Now, now, when you give up, I mean, you can see this in Olympics and in
you can
sports,
see.
I guess, and other places. A skater falls down. Don't give up. Keep on. Do it. Or one time, someone who was cooking something spectacular, and then it fell apart.
Yeah.
Don't give up. And even in the Julia Child show that I do, she tells about a time when she made a tartare, which is an upside-down apple pie with a crust on the top, which then becomes the bottom, and then the caramelized apples are on the top. And when she turns it over to unmold it, it falls apart on the television show.
Wow.
Well, if you have good ingredients and it falls apart, you can still eat it.
Yep.
And so she gathers it up and tries to put the apples back on the top as they're supposed to be and shakes powdered sugar over it and puts it under the broiler. So, you know, she's making the best of what she can do right then. Don't give up,
Yeah. Do you still do your one-woman shows?
Oh, absolutely. I did one yesterday. I did one the day before. I have one on Monday, one on Tuesday, none on Wednesday, two on Thursday, none on Friday, and none on Saturday coming up. But I have a lot of them in the spring and the fall, more than the summer and the winter. But still, I have the three and they're all in my brain.
So you're a busy person.
Yes.
That's how I am with my radio show. I usually do two shows. I try to do two shows a week, and I try to do two actor interviews a month. And I'm busy. Uh-huh. I keep them in my brain, and I go with them. So.
Yes. Yeah. I'm gonna ask you a question, but I forget what it was.
Okay. I'm sure you'll think of it in a minute, I guess. I haven't seen none of your one-woman shows, but I've seen a clip on YouTube and you were doing...
Right, there's a clip of Julia,
Yeah, I've seen that.
Isn't that it?
Yes, it was Julia Child. I forget where it was. It was at a library or something.
Some library, I think. Some library. And I wasn't even aware that they were taking a video of me. I didn't put it up myself, but there it is.
It was incredible. I liked it. I enjoyed it. But,
Thank you. Yeah. I think when I do Julia, I think of her sort of as Raggedy Ann, that she said she was a dropper.
Yeah.
She would drop things. She was tall, and her gestures were floppy. And she leaned on anything she could lean on. And sometimes, she leaned a little too hard, and she'd put her hands on her hips. She'd scratch her nose if she felt like it, at the beginning at least. Usually people don't do that on television.
Yeah.
But so I give myself permission to do that, and I give myself permission to be a ham when I'm doing Julia, because she was a ham in many ways. I mean, she enjoyed the being extravagant and making the large gesture, having something, the biggest spoon that you could find, scaring people with that knife. So, yeah, and then for Eleanor, I wear seamed stockings, mm-hmm. and so I have to have a corset to hold them up, and that sort of holds me in, and my gestures are much more contained, and just gradual and precise and controlled, I'll say.
Yeah, like a classy lady.
And then her son said of her, mm-hmm. anytime she was in trouble, mm-hmm. anytime Eleanor was in trouble, she would stand up straighter. And so I take that, and I stand up straighter whenever I think that she's in trouble.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just pick up these little things after the show of Eleanor, and also the other shows too, but mostly Eleanor. I ask if anyone has had a personal encounter with Eleanor Roosevelt, or a personal memory of Eleanor Roosevelt. Mm-hmm. And lots of people share with me the things that, you know, one person from the Tuskegee Airmen, mm-hmm. was there when she visited.
Yeah.
And one person visited her in Campobello when she was a little girl, and her parents told her, don't go and knock on the Roosevelt's door. Don't bother them. So, of course, the little girls went over and did that, and they got invited to tea. So, you know, just little stories like that people have.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can incorporate them.
Yeah. I have another question. Do you have any advice for young people that want to become actors in their future? Do you have any advice? Or
I think do as much as you can right now. Any school plays.
Yeah.
Find out what you can do, and then read, and memorize. And, you know, if you have a church or synagogue that has a reader that wants you to read something,
yeah.
go ahead, do it. Or Boy Scouts or Girl Scouts or
anything.
You know, whatever you can do,
yeah.
just put yourself out there and do it. I think having a radio show is a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
It makes you do it every week. I think you have been extremely professional in every way that you've contacted me and set things up and everything.
Yeah.
I'm very impressed.
Thank you.
I mean, I don't know whether... I mean, that's one thing, you know, putting yourself out there. Yeah.
Yeah.
When
I first did my radio show, I've been doing this radio show since, I think, November 2014. And I guess like a couple years ago. And at first I didn't want to do it because I would be nervous, you know, people would hear me talking. And nervous, and soon I would talk to celebrities and all that. And, you know, I was a little kid, like 14 or 13, and I would always think, well, celebrities are big shots and I'm not a celebrity. And they would just...
They're real people.
Yeah.
Celebrities are real people too, and often actors, if they're actors,
mm-hmm.
they identify with. I mean, they're very vulnerable, you know.
Yeah.
They identify. They don't go acting big and throwing their weight around. They try to seek the human condition and find out more about it.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's a very humbling experience to be an actor. You have to try to understand other people. You have to try to understand people who are doing bad things.
Yeah.
You're playing a villain. You have to understand what it's like to be inside that person.
Yeah. They're human beings, too. So they're all human.
Yeah, absolutely.
What was your most memorable voice role you did? Was it in The Elder Scrolls Morrowind and Oblivion and Mournhold and stuff? Was that...
That was certainly the funnest, I will say. That those were the funnest, because it was such a range of things, and I really think I did a good job.
Yeah.
In the older days, when they were first coming out with video games, to audition for it, you had to look at the visual and try to form your mouth as around the words of the character that... In other words, you're looking at the visual where the mouth is going, and you're trying to make your mouth go with the words the same way that is already down out there.
Yeah.
But now it's totally different, and they take your words and form the character's mouth around your words. And also they have a way of making the expressions go from like 0 to 100 for, fear, for... joy, for surprise, for disgust, for all kinds of different things, and they had in the margin they had these like neutral or a surprise or something like that from 0 to 100 they would say about how much of it they wanted on each line, and so. You'd read the same line over and over again with different interpretations.
Yeah, different expressions.
It was fun. I mean, and sometimes there was one part where it was a storytelling thing, and there were all these different stories, and there were different kinds of stories.
Mm-hmm.
And so each one had a different attitude. And then, there was a song that I just had to make up on the spot, which I did. And that was fun. I said, do you want me to make up another song? but they were satisfied with that song, so, fine. Yes, it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun to do those.
Yeah.
And I loved also doing The Last of the Czars, because I like languages, and I studied some French and German and Russian and a little Spanish. I even audited Italian for a little bit. I would not say I'm proficient in Spanish or Italian or Russian, but I have a fairly good accent.
Yeah.
And so, when it comes to pronouncing things in those languages, I can do pretty well.
Yeah.
And so that used my French, German, and Russian pronunciations.
Yeah, I'm learning. Well, I'm learning French and Italian. I don't know all of it, but I'm learning to speak.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, French, the spelling is weird.
Yes. Yeah, it's different. Well, many European languages, like, some words come before and after, like, in English, Like...
Right. Yeah. Right, the adjectives sometimes come after the word instead of before.
Yeah.
But sometimes they're before, just...
Yeah. We're on our last minute for our interview. Is there anything else you would like to say, or anything else you would like to say to my audience, or anything?
Well, I wish you all the best, Trey, and I think you're doing a wonderful thing with the radio show, and I give you all my good wishes from right here where I am in Pennsylvania right now.
Yeah. Did you ever think of the question you were going to ask me?
No, I think I was just going to say, I think what I was going to say was I was going to compliment you on the professionalism with which you have contacted me, kept in contact, arranged everything, and the way that you handled the show.
Thank you.
That was what I was going to do. Yeah.
I admire your work too. That I contact actresses and actors that I, inspirations to me. So I contacted you.
Uh-huh. Well, thank you. Yeah, that's good to know. Yes, and I love to do what I do.